Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to be showing you guys a few of my favorite hacks for my Hobonichi notebooks. There are a lot here, so why don't we get started? So my very first hack for you guys today involves stamps. Now I know a lot of people enjoy using stamps in their Hobonichi, but sometimes choosing the stamp inks can be a little bit difficult. I know the VersaColor inks work very well in Hobonichis, but if you guys don't have that, I have a great alternative. As you guys can see here, I am using a mild liner to color in my little alpha stamp. These are rubber stamps, by the way, which I find that they work best with. I'm just coloring in the stamp with this purple mild liner, and I'm just stamping it like regular onto the Tomoe river paper, and I think it turns out really, really well. Another option that you can use if you don't have mild liners are these Crayola Super Tips. These are super cheap and easy to get, and I really like using them in my Hobonichi. I actually prefer them over my mild liners. I find that these work really well on rubber stamps. I tried using clear stamps and it doesn't work very well. The ink doesn't really stay on the stamp. I tried using these with some Michael stamps that I purchased a long time ago. They were really cheap, but they were from the section by the cashier. And I also got the Studio G ink to go with it, and it doesn't really work on the Tomoe river paper. It definitely bleeds, as you can see here. So I don't recommend using anything super strong. This hack might work on certain clear stamps, but with the ones that I have, they haven't been successful for me. So moving on to the first DIY of this video, today I'm going to be showing you guys how I make these cute little tabs that I made in my cousin here. They're super easy, and all of the things that you need are probably in your household already. So what you're going to need for this DIY are some label stickers and some sort of tab sticky note, or for me, I'm using leftover laminating paper. So as you can see here, I'm using these alpha stickers to write out a label on the laminating paper. You can use any sticker or label that you have. I just have these alpha stickers that I really like. I just cut them out with my Silhouette, but you can use anything that you have around your house. You can also use those Avery labels, or you can even use other post-it notes if they fit. But I just wanted to use up some of the items that I already had, so that's why I'm using laminating paper. After I place all of my script stickers onto my laminating sheet, I am now cutting it down into a smaller tab shape, making sure to leave a little bit of room. I decided to use some washi tape to stick down my tab. Here I'm using some Simply Gilded washi because I wanted a little bit of fun glitter and hollowness to my tab. So I'm using this to stick on top of the tab so I can put it into my monthly. I'm using washi in this DIY so that I'll still be able to move the tab if I want to. So that is it for this very simple DIY. I actually also did this tab DIY in my A6 planner, and I think it's super cute and turned out really well. The next hack that I have here is actually only for the Hobonichi Weeks. The Hobonichi Weeks is the only Hobonichi book that has built-in ribbon bookmarks. All of the other sizes and the Hobonichi sneaker do not have bookmarks in them, but have them in their covers. So in order to keep the ribbons from unraveling, I definitely suggest you guys put a little dab of clear nail polish just to seal up the ends. I've also seen people use some charms and cute little things to attach to the ribbons, but I think just adding the clear nail polish is perfectly fine and quite simple. So now we are moving on to stickers. Stickers can be super fun, but sometimes they are very difficult to use with the Tomoe river paper because it is very thin. I personally like to stick my sticker on my hand a couple of times in order to take out some of the tackiness before I place it onto my Hobonichi paper. And this just allows me to have a little bit more playtime with the placement of my stickers. As you can see here, those heart checklist stickers are not coming off of the paper because I stuck them directly from the sticker sheet onto the Tomoe river paper. Whether you are using removable or permanent matte stickers, this hack will work great. Remember that stamp fail from earlier in the video? Well, right now I'm going to show you guys how I like covering up or correcting some of my mistakes in my Hobonichi. As you can see here, I'm just peeling up a piece of extra sticker paper. This is white sticker paper that is just an offcut from one of my sticker sheets, and I'm just cutting it to size, and I'm just going to place it over top of my mistake. It's very simple, very easy, and doesn't cost any extra money. You can also cover up your mistakes using washi or even a picture if you're using it for journaling. I do want to remind you, however, that the Hobonichi Weeks paper is a little bit more on the cream side of coloring versus the other Hobonichi papers. If you have white sticker paper, I think it will work better in the Cousin or in the A6. So here is another DIY for you guys. Today I'm going to be showing you guys how I am going to make a DIY pencil board for my A5. I definitely have been procrastinating. I said I would buy one earlier in a couple of other videos, but I still haven't yet. I actually did another DIY and I've been using some plastic dividers that I got from May Paper Co. a long time ago, but I noticed that as I was using it as a pencil board, my writing would transfer on to those dividers. So I decided I wanted to make something a little bit more durable and that will handle my pen scratches a lot better. So that's why I'm making this out of laminating paper instead. So as you can see here, I am just roughly measuring out where I want my tab to be and the page size of my Hobonichi Cousin, and then I'm going to use my paper cutter to cut it square. You can make the tab any way you want. I just decided to make it a bottom tab. I'm just making a few adjustments to make sure that it is the right size for my Hobonichi Cousin. You can also add a little sticker onto the tab to make it a little bit more noticeable in your planner, but I'm just going to leave it how it is. I did also round the corners of this, by the way, because laminating paper can be sharp. If you don't have laminating paper lying around your house, you also have a variety of different options. You can use cardstock or even cereal boxes if you don't have any of these. I just had this lying around, so that's why I used it. But there you have it. That is my very, very simple DIY. Here I am just testing it out on one of my weekly pages, and it works out really well. So far, I haven't noticed any dents or anything in the laminating paper. However, because this is so cheap, I can always make another one if I do. So this is my very last hack that I'm going to be showing you guys today. We all know that the Hobonichi does have Japanese quotes at the bottom of most of their pages, and with the Google Translate app, you can translate them into whatever language you want. Just download the app and click on the picture icon, and you should be able to hover your phone over some text, and it will automatically translate whatever you are hovering over. Cool, right? So that is it. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. I hope it was interesting for you guys to watch. If you guys enjoyed watching this video, please do give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. It really means a lot to me. I am starting to plan out a few more videos as well, so be sure to stay tuned. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Bye!